United States, Mexico, Canada agreement. So important. I'm honored to be here with President Enrique Peña Nieto. Become a great friend of Mexico and Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, who has also become a great friend. This has been a battle, and battles sometimes make great friendships, so it's really terrific. With our signatures today, we will formally declare the intention of our three countries to replace NAFTA with the USMCA, a truly groundbreaking achievement, modern-day agreement. I want to thank U.S. Trade Representative Bob Lighthizer and his entire team for their tremendous effort and the efforts that they've made all throughout the last almost two-year period. Thank you as well to Jared Kushner, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, Secretary of the Treasury Steve Mnuchin, and Director Larry Kudlow for their hard work and untiring devotion throughout the negotiation process. Peter Navarro, thank you so much for the work that you put in, and so many others. The USMCA is the largest, most significant, modern, and balanced trade agreement in history. All of our countries will benefit greatly. It is probably the largest trade deal ever made also. In the United States, the new trade pact will support high-paying manufacturing jobs and promote greater access for American exports across the range of sectors, including our farming, manufacturing, and service industries. As part of our agreement, the United States will be able to lock in our market access to Canada and Mexico and greatly expand our agricultural exports, something we've been wanting to do for many years. This is an amazing deal for our farmers and also allows them to use cutting-edge biotechnology and eliminates non-scientific barriers. Our nations have also agreed to innovate new measures to ensure fair competition and promote high wages and higher wages for U.S. and North American auto workers. The auto workers are a tremendous beneficiary. Under the USMCA, at least 75% of our automobiles' content must be manufactured in North America, and 40 to 45% of automobile content must be manufactured by North American high-wage labor in order to gain preferential access to our markets. This will help stop auto jobs from going overseas, and it will bring back auto jobs that have already left. Many, many jobs are already planning to come back. Many companies are coming back, and we're very excited about that. This landmark agreement includes intellectual property protection that will be the envy of nations all around the world. The USMCA also contains robust new provisions on digital trade and financial services and the most ambitious environmental and labor protections ever placed into a major trade agreement anywhere at any time. We have dramatically raised standards for combating unfair trade practices, confronting massive subsidies for state-owned enterprises, and currently, if you look at it, currency manipulation that hurt workers in all three of our countries. The currency manipulation from some countries is so intense, so bad, and it would hurt Mexico, Canada, and the United States badly. We've covered it very well in this agreement. These new provisions will benefit labor, technology, and development in each of our nations, leading to much greater growth and opportunity throughout our countries and across North America. In short, this is a model agreement that changes the trade landscape forever, and this is an agreement that, first and foremost, benefits working people, something of great importance to all three of us here today. President, I must say, Peña Nieto and Prime Minister Trudeau, we've worked hard on this agreement. It's been long and hard. We've taken a lot of barbs and a little abuse, and we got there. It's great for all of our countries. Thank you for your close partnership throughout this process. This new agreement will ensure a future of prosperity and innovation for Mexico, Canada, and the United States. I look forward to working with members of Congress and the USMCA partners, and I have to say it's been so well reviewed, I don't expect to have very much of a problem to ensure the complete implementation of our agreement. Enrique, I want to thank you on a personal note, and I want to wish you the very best. This will be your last day in office, so that's a very auspicious day when you can sign something so important, but we really do appreciate it. I think I can speak for Justin when I say that. We both agree he's a special man, and he's really done a good job. We appreciate it very much. Thank you. So I just want to congratulate you on ending your term in office with this incredible milestone. It is really an incredible way to end a presidency. You don't see that happen very often. I look forward to working with President-elect López Obrador for many years to come, and our relationship I know will be a very good one. We've had great conversations, and I think we're going to have a great, great relationship. And I would now like to invite the President and the Prime Minister to say a few words, and perhaps we can start with Justin, and we appreciate it very much. Thank you. Justin, please.
Good morning. Thank you all for being here, and thank you to Presidents Trump and Peña Nieto. Donald, thank you for your words this morning. Thank you for pulling this event together. Enrique, this, as Donald said, on your last day in office, it's a wonderful pleasure to see you and to be here on this historic moment.
Le nouvel accord de libre-échange nord-américain maintient la stabilité et la croissance pour l'économie canadienne. Il protège des millions d'emplois à travers le pays, renforce la classe moyenne et crée de nouvelles opportunités pour nos entreprises. C'est pour ça que je suis ici aujourd'hui, parce que la menace économique qui posait l'incertitude entourant le processus de renégociation était sérieuse et il fallait agir. Et les Canadiens ont répondu à l'appel en travaillant ensemble afin d'arriver à un nouvel accord modernisé qui nous permet d'avoir une relation économique stable et forte avec nos plus importants partenaires.
The new North American Free Trade Agreement maintains stability for Canada's entire economy, stability that's essential for the millions of jobs and middle-class families across the country that rely on strong, reliable trading relationships with our closest neighbors. That's why I'm here today. The new agreement lifts the risk of serious economic uncertainty that lingers throughout a trade renegotiation process. Uncertainty that would have only gotten worse and more damaging had we not reached a new NAFTA. But when faced with this challenge, Canadians came together and rolled up their sleeves. Canadians from every order of government and walks of life put their country's interests first and worked hard to achieve a new, modernized agreement that will protect jobs, strengthen the middle class, and create new opportunities for businesses.
Nous avons plus de travail à faire pour réduire les obstacles au commerce et encourager une croissance économique qui profite au plus grand nombre, mais aujourd'hui, on franchit une étape importante. Nous sommes arrivés à cette entente parce que nous étions motivés par les intérêts communs de la classe moyenne. Nous savons que le commerce plus équitable et plus libre génère des emplois bien payés pour un grand nombre de citoyens.
There's much more work to do in lowering trade barriers and in fostering growth that benefits everyone. But reaching a new free trade agreement with the United States and Mexico is a major step for our economy. Canadians got here because Team Canada was driven by the interests of the middle class. Free and fair trade leads to more and better paying middle class jobs for more people. And the benefits of trade must be broadly and fairly shared. That is what modernizing NAFTA achieves, and that is why it was always so important to get this new agreement done right. As a result, the tariff-free access that NAFTA guaranteed for more than 70% of Canada's total exports is secure. And that's essential for businesses, families, jobs, entrepreneurs, and hardworking people in every corner of our country. As I said, the task isn't done. There is more hard work ahead to build resilient, strong economies that support families everywhere in Canada. As I discussed with President Trump a few days ago, the recent plant closures by General Motors, which affects thousands of Canadian and American workers and their families, are a heavy blow. Make no mistake, we will stand up for our workers and fight for their families and their communities. And Donald, it's all the more reason why we need to keep working to remove the tariffs on steel and aluminum between our countries. Les tarifs sur l'acier et sur l'aluminium demeurent toujours entre nos pays. Et tant qu'ils seront en place, nous allons continuer de travailler fort afin de résoudre cet enjeu qui représente un obstacle majeur à nos économies. With hard work, goodwill, and determination, I'm confident we will get there. Our shared interests, prosperity, and security demand it. Before wrapping up, I'd like to personally thank our Foreign Affairs Minister, Chrystia Freeland, along with U.S. Trade Representative Bob Lighthizer and Mexican Secretary of the Economy, Ildefonso Guajardo, for all their hard work and dedication since the very beginning of this process. I'd also like to thank Ambassador David McNaughton, Chief Negotiator Steve Verhuell, and their talented and extremely hardworking staff. Once again, thank you all for being here today. Merci beaucoup à tout le monde.
Señor presidente de los Estados Unidos, Donald Trump, señor primer ministro de Canadá, Justin Trudeau, muy distinguidos integrantes de las delegaciones que hoy nos acompañan. Ambos quiero agradecerles los comentarios amables y generosos que han formulado hace un momento, justamente en el último día de mi mandato.
That is precisely the last day of my administration, ladies and gentlemen, members of the media.
En el último día de mi gobierno como presidente, me siento profundamente honrado de participar junto a los líderes de dos grandes países, amigos y socios, of two countries, en la firma del nuevo tratado comercial and partners entre México,
in this
Estados
signing ceremony
Unidos
of the
y
new trade agreement between Mexico,
el tratado
the US
que hoy
and Canada. The agreement that we will sign today expresses the shared will by our three nations to work together towards the well-being and prosperity of each one of our societies. This day is the culmination of a long process based on dialogue and negotiations that allow us to overcome differences and to conciliate our visions. Once signed, the agreement will be sent to our congresses for its ratification. It will be then when this innovative instrument bears fruit by offering a more inclusive, firm, and modern foundation for our future exchanges. The negotiation of USMCA allowed to reaffirm the importance of economic integration in North America. For more than a quarter of a century ago, our three countries have maintained very tight trade relationships. Such trade has transformed Mexico. Today, our exchanges abroad represent more than 70% of our gross domestic product.
Los beneficios del comercio con el mundo sean ampliamente apreciados por la sociedad mexicana. La renegociación del nuevo acuerdo comercial buscó salvaguardar la visión de una América del Norte integrada,
North America, with a firm belief that together we are stronger and more competitive.
A pesar de lo mucho que nuestra relación comercial avanzó en las últimas décadas,
that we've seen in our trade relations in the last two decades, there was still a long road ahead of us to take advantage of each country's potential.
México, Estados Unidos y Canadá,
the United States-Mexico-Canada agreement gives a renewed face to the process of integration. This process achieved, in the first place, to modernize our trade framework. Trade agreements shall not be static. Agreements need to move along with the economy and should be according to the needs of our society, the inclusion of new provisions on e-commerce, information technologies and trade enabling practices are now part of the agreement. In fact, one-third of the agreement includes topics that were not included in the current agreement. The renegotiation process of the agreement allowed a region to move into a more inclusive integration, a type of integration that listens to the demands of our societies. 24 years ago, NAFTA set a new benchmark for trade agreements back then. Today, USMCA is the first trade agreement that incorporates elements that address the social impact of international trade. It enables the participation of more sectors in the economy, including the participation of SMEs in regional trade. It extends the protection of workers' rights, strengthens the protection of the environment, and also includes a review clause that would make easier that the agreement is revamped more constantly. And this is a true sign of the will we have put in this agreement, the decision to provide more and better opportunities to our people. I would like to acknowledge the work done by the negotiators from the three countries. Each team advocated for each country's interests, and by doing this, you reached a very positive result for the sake of all countries. In the case of Mexico, this work bears testimony of the work of the business community who were present during the process, and specifically the new administration that will take office tomorrow. Your support and the alignment of visions in the last phase contributed to the success of this renegotiation process. I would like to say that I sincerely acknowledge President Trump and Prime Minister Trudeau for their vision and the vision that they have put into the process. Thanks to you, President Trump and Prime Minister Trudeau, the agreement that we have signed today will allow each country to gain individually, but also North America will grow stronger and will grow to be more prosperous. Ladies and gentlemen, currently in the world, each country's future is firmly linked to what happens in other countries. In North America, we understand this very clearly. We understand that each society's prosperity will be greater and will be deeply rooted if it's based in the prosperity of the region as a whole. This signing ceremony, it is a sign that Mexico, the United States, and Canada, being close not only due to our geography, but on values and our expectations, we are ready to begin a new chapter in our shared history. Thank you very much.
Which is the one that matters.
Each of us get a copy.
Which
Sounds very good, yes. Okay, thank you very much, everybody. You guys will have that. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.